currently what are you doing? Just tell me about you, madam.
Okay, actually I have done a master's. This is international business.
Okay.
I'm not from technical background, but I'm working in an IT company where it is required for me to have knowledge on testing because my company is into
Okay.
It's a software test lab, so they are into testing. So I'm working in the management side, but now they want me to learn the testing and everything so that whenever there is a project.
Oh, great. So first question, why did you, do you know anything about manual testing? Something, you know, something manual testing, right?
Yeah, I know about manual testing. Yes.
Yes. So why did you choose this testing, madam?
Yeah. Actually, it is quite easy to go
with. Why did you choose this testing?
In the beginning, though I know, I chose it because it's easy to do it. And even because it is like, at the moment, in most of the company, it is running.
Whenever
like,
you are facing
to start mental... with, to learn, start, to learn.
All right.
Yeah. I think for a non-technical person, it is quite easy to go for manual testing before then go for automation to something like that.
Whenever you are working with software company also, or after this class completion or course completion, somebody will ask you like, why did you choose this testing? What will you say?
Testing is because like it...
If you say it's very easy, that's the reason I'm learning, then they will feel easy.
Oh, okay, then what should I answer them?
Yes, that answer I will tell you, madam. Why did you choose this testing? First point.
Mm-hmm.
Scope of getting job is very high.
Okay.
Scope of getting job is very high.
Okay.
Scope of getting job is very high. Scope of getting job is very high.
Very high. Okay.
Why I'm saying scope of getting job is very high? For example, in Hyderabad city, we have 3,000 companies. So each and every software company may not maintain Java people, SAP people, .NET people, PHP people. But each and every software company wants testers. Each and every software company compulsory, they will maintain test engineer. That means each and every software company wants testers. So scope of getting job is very, very high. Scope of getting job is very, very high. Why? Because after developing the project, compulsory we need to test the project. So if you want to test the project, compulsory test engineers required. Not only the Hyderabad companies, wherever you go. If it is software company, compulsory they will develop some projects or products. After developing the project or product, compulsory we need to do testing. So that means this 3,000 companies, compulsory they will recruit test engineers. That means scope of getting job is very, 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 very high. Second point. No need to depend upon other technologies. No need to depend upon other technologies. No need to depend upon other technologies. Without knowing anything, we can learn these testing tools nowadays. Even BA/BCom people also, they are doing this course. It's very easy to learn. And after course completion also, easily we can keep the experience and we can try for job. That much of facilities we have in only testing area. That's the reason non-IT background people and both IT background people also, they are learning these testing tools. Why? Because it's very easy to learn. And after course completion, easily we can keep the experience and we can try for job. And here is the daily updations not required. Once if you learn testing tools, you can settle in your life. So that's the reason most of the people, they are choosing this testing. And at the same time, this is one of the drawback, but still I need to say. So wherever you go, IT background people, IT background people also, sometimes they will, if they are not in good coding area, that time they are choosing this testing only. Non-IT background people, they don't have any other alternate. That's the reason they are choosing this testing only. Heavy competition only on testing, not only in Hyderabad, not only in US. Wherever you go, heavy competition only on testing. Why? Because it's very easy to learn, and after course completion also easily we can keep the experience, and after getting job also we can manage our job very easy, and daily updations are not required. It is cool job, 9-to-6 job. That's the reason most of the people, even housewives also, they are choosing only this testing. So it's very easy. And no need to depend upon other technologies. If you want to learn testing, so no need of any other technologies. No need to know anything. Without knowing anything directly, we can learn these testing tools. So no need to depend upon other technologies. And third point, testing remains forever. Testing remains forever. Why I'm saying testing remains forever? Testing remains forever. Why I'm saying testing remains forever? So here right now, leading technology is Java. For example, leading technology is Java. For example, leading technology is Java. Today, leading technology is Java. Tomorrow, Kava will come. Day after tomorrow, Mava will come. If it is developed by any technology, compulsory we need to do testing. If it is developed by any technology, actually whenever they want to develop the application, they will choose three technologies, Java or PHP or .NET. So not only these three technologies, tomorrow Kava will come, day after tomorrow Mava will come to market. So in that situation also, if it is developed by any technology, so compulsory we need to do testing. That means testing remains forever. Testing remains forever. And the fourth point.
Okay.
Fourth point. I want consistent life. That's the reason I'm choosing this testing. So scope of getting job is very high. No need to depend upon other technologies. Testing remains forever. I want consistent life. That's the reason I'm choosing this testing. That's the reason I'm choosing this testing. So if you say this answer, they will feel very happy. So she knows something. She know already. That's the reason she is learning. They can feel.
Okay.
Right. Next question. What exactly we required to get a job, madam?
Knowledge, experience, mainly experience, I think. At the moment, it's quite...
What exactly we required to get a job? What exactly we required to get a job? What we need, madam, if you want job, what we need?
Experience.
Okay.
Is it? Of course, knowledge
on
certain
If you work as a fresher, there is no need of any experience. First one is subject. Or stuff, or knowledge. So if you are learning testing knowledge, if it is Java, Java knowledge, if it is Oracle knowledge, if it is SAP, SAP knowledge, subject is very, very important. So I have subject. Can I get the job?
Yeah, at least you should have knowledge on that.
Yes, I know knowledge. I have knowledge.
Okay, then.
Can I get the job?
Yeah. I think if you have knowledge on subject, then it depends how you crack the interview. That's what I can say.
So nowadays, next one is communication also very, very important.
Okay.
Communication. I have subject and communication. Can I get the job?
Depends.
I have subject and communication. Can I get the job? No.
No.
We need confidence. Confidence is very, very important. Whenever you want to, whenever you are facing the interview also, that time they are totally concentrating on person capability. She can do or not, he can do or not, they are concentrating. Confidence is even more important. So confidence, if you have less subject, we can manage. If you have less communication, we can manage. If you have less confidence, we can't manage. If you want to get a job, not only in Hyderabad, wherever you go, confidence is very, very important. Confidence is very, very important. Not only getting job, after getting job also, we can face number of problematic situation. If you want to face each and every problematic situation, we need confidence. Confidence is very, very important. Not only doing job, if you want to do business, if you want to do any other work, we need confidence. Confidence is very, very important. So nowadays they are not concentrating on your percentage, educational qualification and percentage. If you have confidence, you can get job anywhere in the world. So if you don't have any confidence, you can't get any job anywhere in the world. And fourth point, dynamism. Dynamism means based on the situation dynamically we should change. Dynamism means based on the situation dynamically we should change. That is called dynamism. I will tell you one small example. Recently one of the girl, she completed MCA. After that she got job in MNC company. She kept experience and degree. Finally she got job in good MNC company. Good MNC company. A nice day, a fine day, she went to lunch with her team member. She went to lunch with her team member. He asked, Madam, how many years of experience do you have? Currently, how much you are getting? He said, Sir, I have 3+ years of experience. Currently, I am getting 6.6 lakh package. Actually, that fellow is working in the same company from 4 years. He is getting only 5 lakh package. So, next day, he went to team manager. He went to team manager cabin. Sir, he raised one doubt. Sir, I'm working in the same company from 4 years. I'm getting only 5 lakh package. Why is she getting 6 lakhs? 6.6. He raised one doubt. Hey, next day, that project manager called Shirisha and he said, apply for relieving. So, she applied relieving. She lost job. Who did mistake? Okay. Who did mistake here? Shirisha, that fellow or project manager?
I think the project manager.
No.
Shirisha?
Right.
Yeah, because she lied. She lied, I think. Yeah.
Not lied, madam. That is a confidential issue. No need to share with others. So, that is dynamism.
Okay.
Dynamism. Based on the situation, okay, dynamically we should change. If you ask my salary, then I can skip it. You can skip it. So that is, she did one mistake, that is dynamism. She has subject, she has communication, she has confidence. She doesn't have dynamism. She left, she lost job. So that means, so if you want to get a job anywhere in the world, we need this 4 things. Subject, communication, confidence, dynamism. Not only getting job, madam, after getting job also we can face number of problematic situations. So if you want to face each and every problematic situation, we need dynamism or confidence. Communication and the subject, all are very, very important. Okay. All right. So, wherever you go, there are two types of companies, madam. Wherever you go, there are two types of companies. One is project-based company. Other one is product-based company. Wherever you go, there are two types of companies. Not only in India, wherever you go, there are two types of companies. One is project-based company. Other one is product-based company. Okay, wherever you go, there are two types of companies. Wherever you go, there are two types of companies. One is project-based company, other one is product-based company. Now tell me, madam, what do you mean by project, what do you mean by product? Currently, you are working in one software company, some market. So, compulsory, you should know something. So, what do you mean by project, what do you mean by product?
Project companies are basically the service providers, I believe, getting the project from other companies like Accenture and somebody. They are getting the projects from other like banks and all that in order to develop their application or something, pay system, something like that. So they are developing that project and testing on that. And product are the companies, example, if I'm not wrong, product are the companies who are like, who are selling their own products in terms of applications or in terms of any tangible product, example, Apple is there, Samsung is there, they develop their own product and this test their product and they sell it.
Yeah, there are two types of companies, madam. One is project-based company, other one is product-based company. You said right, madam. But what do you mean by project, what do you mean by product? I will tell you with a small example. Small example, with a silly example, simple example, madam. So, with a simple example, okay, I will tell you. For example, you got good job in MNC company, madam. You got good job in MNC company. So your friends are asking treat. So you are currently in UK. So okay, where are you from? Actually, you are from India or any country?
Yeah.
You are from?
No,
India?
I'm from Lucknow actually.
Lucknow.
Lucknow, Hindi.
Okay. So for example, you got good job in MNC company, madam. Your friends are asking treat party. So if you want to give the party compulsory, we should provide some sweets in your home. So if you want to give the party in your home only, in UK, you want to give the party in your home. So if you want to give the party compulsory, we should provide some sweets. You inquired which is the best sweet house is famous for sweets in UK. So finally, you got information. Akhil Reddy Sweet House is famous for sweets. Akhil Reddy Sweet House is famous for sweets. Recently, he established one sweet house, that is Akhil Reddy Sweet House. Akhil Reddy Sweet House. First, you will go to Akhil Reddy Sweet House. Why? Because if you want to prepare the sweets, so it is very difficult for you. Only you are the only one person. If you want to prepare the sweets, compulsory, it is very difficult. So that's the reason you inquired which is the best software, which best sweet house for sweets. Finally, you got information. Akhil Reddy Sweet House is famous for sweet. So you want laddu. You want laddu. For example, you are going to Akhil Reddy Sweet House. You are telling your requirements. Sir, I want 100 laddus. Each and every lad should be X size. Each and every lad should be light sugar. Each and every lad should be light brownish. You are saying four requirements. You are saying four requirements. Sir, we want 100 laddus. Each and every lad should be X size. Each and every lad should be light sugar. Each and every lad should be light brownish. Based on your requirements, if they prepare laddu, that is called a project. Project is something that is developed based on the particular customer requirements and used by that particular customer only. That is called project. Project is something that is developed based on the particular customer requirements and used by that particular customer only. That is called project. Project is something that is developed based on the particular customer requirements and used by that particular customer only. If it is laddu is X size, I hate. That's my requirement. Your requirement is you want laddu, there should be X size. So based on your requirements, if they prepare laddu, that is called project. That is called project. Project is something that is developed based on the particular customer requirement and used by that particular customer only. That is called project. Whenever you are going to Akhil Reddy Sweet House, already they prepared small size laddus, medium size laddus, big size laddus. That is called product. That is called product. Product is something that is developed based on the company specification and used by multiple people. That is called product. So project means based on the particular customer requirements, they will develop. Product means based on the company specification, they will develop and they will release into market. If you are interested, you can buy and you can use it. So that is called product. Project-based company, best example, Infosys. Product-based company, best example is Microsoft. So, best example, Microsoft. They will develop some product. So, they will release it into market. If you are interested, you can buy and you can use it. So, our soap is a product. Our paste is a product. Our brush is a product. Our laptop is a product. Our desktop is a product. Our soap is a product. Our pen is a product. All our products. So, if you are interested, you can buy and you can use it. So, your headphones, your mobile phone, your laptop or desktop, all our products. Based on the requirements they prepared, if you are interested, you can buy and you can use it. That is called product. Based on this example, can you tell me what do you mean by quality, what do you mean by defect?
Quality. Okay, based on the example you have given. Example, quality is like how effectively you have like completed, I mean, you have fulfilled my requirements.
Yes.
So, defect. And defect is something, is example, if I said that to put light sugar and there is not light sugar, you put different sugar in that. So, there might be a defect in that.
Yes.
So, that's, yeah. So, sure. This is quality and defect.
Yes. Customer is said for requirements. So, if you satisfy all the requirements, that is called quality. Quality is nothing but justification of all the customer requirements. If you justify all the customer requirements, that is called quality. If you justify all the customer requirements, that is called quality. Defect is nothing but deviation from the particular customer requirement. If it is any requirement deviated, that is called defect. If it is any requirement deviated, for example, he said 100 laddus, you said 100 laddus, but they prepared only 90 laddus. So that is called defect. Defect is nothing but deviation from the particular customer requirements. If it is any requirement deviated, that is called defect. If it is any requirement deviated, that is called defect. Next. For example, I see these four terms regularly we will use in software company, madam. Regularly we will use in software company. Project to product to defect to and quality. These four terms regularly we will use in software company, madam. Whenever you are working with a software company, compulsory we will use these four terms. For example, ICICI bank people want one software. They inquired which is the best company for developing the software. Finally, they got information. Infosys is the best. So they will go to Infosys first of all, and they will tell the all the requirements. Based on the requirements that Infosys people will analyze. Based on the customer requirement, this project is possible or not, they will analyze. If they feel yes, then they will give one estimation. After estimation, they will write the estimation. For example, they are giving a requirement is they want one software. That software should work in Windows 7 environment, and they want to implement 150 branches in Hyderabad city. For example, they want to implement that project in 150 branches in Hyderabad city. Based on the requirement, they gave estimation is 3 months time and 3 crore rupees. This estimation, if they feel reasonable, then they will write official agreement. ICICI Bank people want one software. They inquired which is the best software company for developing the software. Finally, they got information. Infosys is the best. First, they will go to Infosys and they will tell all the requirements very clearly. After telling the requirements, based on the requirements, they will give one estimation. After estimation, if they feel reasonable, then they will write official agreement. This official agreement in software company we are calling bidding the project or signed off. Normally we will call official agreement in software company we are calling bidding the project or signed off. After official agreement, each and every software company, they will conduct one meeting. That meeting name is kickoff meeting. Kickoff meeting is nothing but this is the first meeting or initial meeting conducted in the software company. Soon after the project is signed off. After official agreement, each and every software company, they will conduct one meeting. That meeting name is kickoff meeting. Kickoff meeting is nothing but this is the first meeting or initial meeting. So in this meeting, why they are conducting? So they want to intimate the information to all high level authorities. So and so, madam came to here and she gave some requirements, or so and so ICICI Bank people came here and they gave some requirements. Based on the requirements, we gave one estimation. If it is needed, so anytime, so your cooperation also very important, or we need. So that is the reason they want to intimate the information to all the high level authorities. They will conduct one meeting. That meeting name is kickoff meeting. Kickoff meeting is nothing but this is the first meeting or initial meeting conducted in the software company. In this meeting, high level management people will be participate, like quality managers, team leads, quality leads will be participate in this meeting. That meeting name is kickoff meeting. So in this kickoff meeting, they will select one project manager for this particular project. Only this particular project purpose, they will select one project manager. After selecting the project manager, he will prepare one mail. You will prepare one mail and you will send it to CEO of software company. You will send it to CEO of software company. You will send it to CEO of software company. Sir, this is Akhil Reddy, sir. Yesterday we conducted kickoff meeting. I got selected as a project manager. Please give the permission to start this particular project. He will prepare one mail and he will send it to CEO of software company. That is called PIN. PIN means project initiation note. Project initiation note. Project initiation note. It is a note prepared by project manager and sent to CEO of software company in order to get the permission to start this particular project. So if you're getting the project, if you get the permission, then you can start the project. So wherever you go, if it is any software company, they will follow these steps. After approaching the customer, they will conduct one kickoff meeting. In this meeting, they will select project manager. He will prepare one mail and he will send it to CEO of software company for permission. So after getting the permission, we can start the project. That mail is called project initiation note. It is a note prepared by project manager and sent to CEO of software company in order to get the permission to start this particular project. That is called PIN. So in testing, first concept is SDLC, software development lifecycle. Next concept, only first concept in testing, that is SDLC. Already you know something about SDLC. Tomorrow we will discuss SDLC. So another people also inquired today only just. So SDLC, before your class, I got one call from UK. So they are also interested. I said 12 o'clock, I will give demo tomorrow 11 o'clock and 12 o'clock we have class. Exactly every day, okay. 12 o'clock we have class. So some other people, UK, she's name is Sunita. Sunita also, she is interested. So tomorrow onwards, she can continue with you. So SDLC, okay, software development life cycle. Yes, madam. Now ask me doubts.
Yes, sir.